What is up, beautiful people? Welcome back to a new video. Today, we're going to be talking about Alex Eubank, and no, I'm just kidding. A lot of people were asking about my opinion on the whole thing, so it's like, I mean, I don't want to get involved with the whole drama if you don't know what's happening. A couple fellas were exposed for Photoshop, morphing their physiques a little bit, and they just all happened to be on Raw Gear, so there's a lot of drama. It's like the young LA kids were using as ammunition, because we, we don't like Raw Gear. I mean, I don't like Raw Gear, fuck it. But just like back and forth, because they already got beef, so it was just like ammunition. Yeah, I mean, Photoshop isn't good, and that's universally known. I've never done it on my mama. I would never Photoshop my shit. To kind of look at it as this perspective of being natural, like I'm natural. My whole premise is setting up a realistic expectation for like what's attainable naturally. So it's like, why the fuck would I morph my pictures into something that I'm not? Even if it's the littlest. So it's like, that's my stance on it. I got body dysmorphia, but to counter my body dysmorphia, I just get shredded. So I don't have to edit my pictures. Rumor they were gonna do a podcast. Bradley Martin wanted to do a podcast and stuff and expose everything. I don't know. I don't know why people are so fucking worried about what other people are doing. Yeah. I wake up, I eat my fucking cereal, I record my TikToks. And then I move on with my day. The 19th through the 23rd, I'm going to LA. I'm gonna lift with Lex. I'm gonna do some photo shoots and stuff. Oh, for cutting. I was 185 this morning. So I'm like really fucking low. I'm starting to feel more sluggish, getting hungrier. Just like shit like that. Like I'm starting to finally feel the cut. But thank God, because I'm only gonna cut until I leave to LA. So like 5 more days, literally. I'm pretty happy with where I'm at. You got some penis skin going. Yeah, so I'll probably go to LA, kind of like enjoy stuff in LA. But when I get back, I'm gonna start like a bulk series, teach you guys how to bulk. Cause I did a bulk series before, but I wasn't really like doing YouTube like that. I want you guys to see like how to bulk, cause I get questions about it all the time. I'm like working so hard to get shredded and people are like, how do you bulk? We got Delton Arms today. I've low-key been thinking about going back to powerlifting. Should I powerlift or should I bodybuild? Like just full-on send powerlifting? I'll even fucking do a meet or some shit. Like I'm about it. In like a year or something, just get stupid strong and do a meet. Oh no. We'll see. I also just got a code for Helomix. Code Monkey, Helomix, it's live. Surprise package. Damn, our duct tape is so much better quality than Raw Gear's duct tape. And this came in like 3 days. Is this new drop? Oh, they're gonna fucking shit. No, let me get the gray ones. I know exactly what these are. Oversized sweats. I'm putting these on right now. Hold on. Oh yeah. I like these. Most like baggy gray sweats, there's just never pockets. So, this is nice. These are dropping on the 24th. If I'm wrong, I'll put the right date. 24th. If there's nothing there, it's the 24th. What are these? Look at that. A little Young LA on the back. They always make the most fire cutoffs too. Look how stretchy this bitch is.
Sheesh.
Holy fuck. Is this like just a nice clean shirt? Oh, that's clean. No, I'm gonna wear this too. You get first genuine raw reaction. Not photoshopped.
Listen, that's comfy.
Dude, that's nice. I always feel like a fucking superhero when I wear the stretchy shit. Damn, shit. That's gonna be on the 24th. Code Monkey. Ain't life sweet?
Yeah, I sort of see it a little cute.
Wait, isn't that a fucking lemon?
The lemons. Spicy?
Sour. Sour! Spicy lemons? Lemons are universally known for being sour, and you're like, were they spicy? First thing I wish I knew before I started lifting. Diet is severely, heavily underrated. I see too many people DMing me, Max, how do you bulk? And I'm like, bro, you have to eat in a caloric surplus. And they're like, bro, I already eat so much, dog, and I'm not gaining weight. I literally eat everything under the sun. And I'm like, dog, if you think about it, some days you eat more caloric dense foods than others because I know your ass ain't tracking your food. If you're eating everything under the sun, they're eating fucking gas station burritos, fucking Ben and Jerry's ice cream. I was guilty of that. So I know what you're doing. And then probably my 1300 calorie shake they watched a couple months ago. Literally, the more consistent your diet is, the more consistent you will make progress. So if you track everything, you can play with more variables,
you can know how you're progressing because weight will move up linearly. So it's like, if I want to bulk and my calculated caloric surplus is 3,500 calories, if I eat 5,000 calories one day, and then the next day you're not that hungry and you eat 2,000, you're fucked. You're in a deficit that day. You're not making progress that day. So you're only getting like, if you do that, like 2,000, 3,000, 7,000, 5,000, then you're only making bulk caloric surplus progress like 3 days out of the week. Imagine that over a year. You're getting like 140 wasted days of not bulking. Honestly, just caloric dense foods. Eggs, fatter beef.
Peanut butter.
That shit is like one spoonful is 190 calories.
Yeah.
Just fuck, dog. I'm giving you guys like the blueprint on how to make gains, and you're still asking me how to make gains. I done told you how to make gains. I forgot my Rice Krispie.
Oh, shoot.
God damn.
Fuck, dude, that always takes me like 6 tries. Gotta shoulder press first. This was like after DMA. Your shit does not work. People always comment about my failure face, like when I hit failure. They expect me to look like Nate Garner. Like obviously I'm gonna be like, I hit failure. I'm just gonna start doing that, force myself to smolder on my last rep. Number two, things I wish I knew before I started lifting. Form overweight. When I took that into account, that's when I made the most progress. When I first started back up on powerlifting, I took like literally 2 months of just doing form before I went heavy on anything. Dialing in your form, it's not only gonna make you stronger in the long run, it's more optimal and healthy for your joints and ligaments and stuff. Especially with muscle breakdown for a tricep extension. If, let's say you extend all the way, but if you go right here, you're missing out on this whole part of tearing your muscle, literally. Like this much gains. That was kind of sus. You even see me in my barbell rows. I'm like fully bent over, strict rowing with it. Just dialing that form, you can make a lot more gains, trust me. Feeling discredited. I remember when it's like peak Natty or not, everyone's like, everyone tag Greg Doucette. Oh, well, by the way, I'm having my last cheat meal before the cut ends. It wasn't necessarily that like my weight plateaued, but I was feeling like extra shitty. So I'm like, I'm just gonna give myself a refeed, a little cheat. But the last thing I wish I knew before I started lifting is sleeping is the best thing you can do for recovery. So, I mean, when I first started, I was in high school and I couldn't really get the most optimal sleep because I worked. I had a girlfriend at the time. And I was going to school, like high school. Like, it's not like I can just call out of high school. Like, I had to go. So I was only sleeping like 4 hours a night, and I felt like shit in the gym. I performed worse. I wasn't recovering because you already know I was going ham in the gym, so I just wasn't recovering. I noticed that
also, when I took more rest days, I got better results. So I think like 2 rest days is a sweet spot for me. Some people take more, and I mean, 4 is more rest, so it's more optimal. I just like being in the gym a little bit more. But I think you should be sleeping like 8 hours minimum a night. And I know it's hard, but whether that means you're not on your phone the last hour of the night and just shut it off and go to bed, or just like setting a better schedule for yourself. So like plan out your days and make sure you're getting enough sleep. Because I mean, when I started sleeping, my gains, like, I'm still making gains, and I've been in the gym like 6 years and I'm natural. So it's like, when you control the variables, it works out. So you gotta sleep, bruh. But we're about to kill this burger. I got a burger, fries, and a shake. Shake probably isn't the most optimal thing for a refeed, but we got the fries. Fuck, I hate when the burger's under it. Boom. I don't know why some people are like Five Guys haters. Like, grow up. But the same people will be like, In-N-Out's better than Five Guys. Not even close. Fries alone put them above. Oh my god. I'm literally in a food coma. If that's like a real thing, I'm feeling it right now.
Still have abs though, thank god.
5 more days of the cut. I'm probably gonna be like super strict the next 5 days. And then once I go to LA, that's like gonna commence the bulk. Cause I'm sure I'm gonna eat like whatever. I mean, depending on what's around, I'm probably gonna have to fucking DoorDash everything. Cause it's not like, I don't have a meal prep sponsor or anything yet. I don't have a meal prep sponsor. But yeah, so next video will most likely be in LA with my boy Lex. So we'll see you then. But other than that, I think that's it. Peace.